Hi boys and girls, lovely to see you again. It really is. Are you eating? What's in your mouth? I hope you wanted more sweets. Let me see what's behind your back. Stephen, that was a full box of sweets.
I only need a few, Grace.
Look at your belly. When are you going to start your dad?
Next year.
Oh, what would you do with him?
I'm always getting told off. Well, boys and girls, it's great to see you back tonight. Hope you all had a lovely Christmas and got lots of lovely presents.
And boys and girls, we really are pleased to be back again. We've missed you all so much. We really, really have. And we want to share tonight all the wonderful stories and courses and memory verses that remind us so much of how much the Lord Jesus loves us all. Now, I think tonight, maybe we're going to start in prayer first, are we?
Good idea.
So, boys and girls, close your eyes and don't talk and listen to what Stephen talks to God.
Dear Lord, our Heavenly Father, I just pray, Lord, you bless CET Kids tonight. Bless you when it takes part, but most of all, Lord, that the boys and girls will learn about the Lord Jesus Christ, and hopefully some will get saved. Amen.
Amen. And boys and girls, we want to start tonight with Sarah and Andrew. Now, Sarah's a lovely singer, and I hope tonight that she sings along with her chorus.
Yes, and I hope Andrew sings his favourite song.
Oh, I hope so. We'll go over to them now. Okay.
Hello boys and girls, thank you for joining us in CET Kids. We're going to sing Living, Loving, Lasting God. Up on your feet.
God is living.
Boys and girls, I have my favourite song here, it's the Lord's Army, and if you know me, I love this song, so I want to get you all up on your feet, stand tall, shoulders back, and get ready for the Lord's Army. Let's get ready to march.
Thank you.
See you, boys and girls. Bye.
Thanks, Audrey and Sarah, for those wonderful songs. Now it's time to go over to Helen.
And I think it's the first part of an amazing story. So all sit up, fold your arms, and ready to listen, okay?
Hello, boys and girls. Thank you for joining me. Over the next 2 weeks, I'll be bringing you a really exciting, true story. And this story is about a little girl, and her name was Amy Carmichael. Now, Amy was born 154 years ago in 1867 in the village of Malyle, just outside Bangor. And she was born there to a minister and his wife, and she was the oldest of seven children. They lived in a big farmhouse on the side of the sea, and they could hear the sea and the wind whistling down the big chimney in the nursery where they had all slept together. Now, Amy had always been told that God answers prayer every time, not just sometimes, but he always answered prayer. And Amy loved the colour blue. Her mummy had the most beautiful blue eyes that you ever had seen in your whole life. And Amy thought, oh, I would love blue eyes like my mummy. So I'm going to pray and ask God for blue eyes. So that night, Amy did. She prayed to God and she asked for blue eyes. She really meant it. Every word she said, dear Lord, please give me blue eyes like my mummy. And she went to bed that night and she never thought another thing about it. Before long, she was... Many of you sleep and snore. I think I snore. But since I live on my own, nobody has ever told me any different. So there you go. I can snore as much as I want. The next morning when Amy woke up, she thought to herself, oh yes, I prayed to God and I asked him for blue eyes. So she went over to the mirror, and what did she see? Oh, she was really disappointed, because instead of blue eyes, there she had two lovely brown eyes staring back at her. Oh, she was really disappointed. I thought God always answers prayer, but he hasn't answered my prayer. But you know, boys and girls, God does always answer prayer, but he answers in three ways. Sometimes it's yes, and that's brilliant when it's yes, isn't it? Sometimes it's no. Oh, it's not so easy to take whenever it's no, but God always knows best, because he has a plan for your life and for mine. And sometimes he says, wait. Oh, boys and girls, and even grown-ups, we hate to wait, don't we? We like our answers there and then. But suddenly, as if she heard it, a little voice saying, but isn't no an answer? And so she realized God had answered her prayer, not just the way she wanted. Now, not many years later, Amy had always been told that God loved her. And she always knew that the Lord Jesus had died on the cross to take away her sin. But it just seemed to go over her head. She never thought anything about it until one Sunday she was at church. And what were they singing, boys and girls? Only the wee song that we love so well. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me, the Bible tells me so. And it was during the singing of the second verse that Amy realized that the Lord Jesus died for her. And so whenever they started singing, Jesus loves me, he who died, heaven's gates to open wide, he will wash away my sin, let a little child come in. And Amy there and then prayed, closed her eyes and prayed and asked the Lord Jesus to take away her sin, and thanked him for dying on the cross for her, and to come into her heart and to be her Lord and her Saviour. You know, boys and girls, it's very important that you know that just because your mummy and daddy are Christians, that doesn't make you a Christian. You have to ask the Lord Jesus into your heart to take away your sin for yourself, just like Amy did. Even though her mummy and daddy where he was a minister and she was a minister's wife, it didn't make Amy a Christian. It was only when she trusted the Lord for herself that she became a Christian. When does somebody become a missionary? Well, I believe boys and girls can be missionaries right from the time they trust the Lord Jesus as their Saviour, because that's just one person telling another person about the Lord Jesus Christ and bringing them along to meetings when the wee meetings are on, or telling them about CET Kids, put my teeth back in, CET Kids, and well, telling them that they need to know the Lord Jesus as their Saviour. Well, Amy not only trusted the Lord as her Saviour, but she worked really hard for him. And one Sunday she was going to church and just seen this old lady with a whole bundle of clothes, and she was struggling to carry the clothes. And Amy went and said to her, "Can I help you?" And all of the people going into church were laughing at Amy. But Amy didn't care, because she was doing what the Lord Jesus had told her to do, to go and help others and bear one another's burdens. Already, the Lord was working in her heart to care for people. Now, in the city of Belfast were these young girls called Shawleys. That meant they worked in the factories. They didn't live in really fancy houses, and maybe they were a wee bit dirty. And they weren't allowed to go into the churches. Imagine, people in church didn't want them to come in. And so Amy and friends decided that they would get together and try to raise money to build this hall called the Welcome Hall, so that these Shawleys could come and hear about the Lord Jesus Christ. And so the only way that she thought, "I can really help these Shawleys," is to just go and live among them. And that's what she did. She got a room and she got to know the Shawleys. She got to tell them about the Lord Jesus. And when the Welcome Hall was built, well, she was in the right place to ask them in. Sometimes, you know, Amy could have been in danger. And walking through the streets of Belfast one time, she was walking back to her house, and this crowd of boys kept coming after her more and more, and she started to get scared. Yes, even though she was a Christian, she was scared. But she did know that God would protect her, and she started to pray, "Oh dear Lord, protect me, watch over me." And suddenly from nowhere, a woman stepped out of her doorway, pulled Amy in and closed the door, and she was safe. You know, boys and girls, God does look after his children, his boys and girls and grown-ups that trust in him. If we trust in him, he has promised that nothing will harm us out of his will. I wonder if you trusted the Lord Jesus. Can you say that he is with you each day? Now, Amy grew in grace. Do you know that I've told you, like, we like to grow in grace and do the things that God asks us to do, to read our Bible and to pray? And God then spoke to Amy and he asked her to do something. He asked her to leave her home and go to the land of India to be a missionary for him. Now, next week, we're going to go with Amy as she starts her journey to the land of India, and we're going to discover the wonderful plan and purpose that God had, that she was given brown eyes. So on to next week. Goodbye. God bless you.
Thanks, Helen. It's a wonderful story. We look forward to next week to hear the rest of it.
Yeah. Now, I think we're going over to Paul and Glenda now for a couple of action courses. So everybody up on your feet and start to get ready for all these actions, okay?
Hello everybody, this is Shane. You live in me.
Hi everybody, we're going to sing God, You're Good to Me. On your feet, and we'll do the actions.
Give to me, gave it up and set me free.
Linda and Paul for those wonderful choruses. We really enjoyed them.
Yeah, boys and girls, and now it's time to go to our memory verse. You know, our memory verse is found in the Bible, and this is my big, big Bible. It's maybe big because I'm getting older and I have to see the big writing in it, but I love this big Bible. And look at this one. I love that wee small Bible too. And you know, every word in my Bible is true, and it teaches me so much about the Lord Jesus, so many Bible stories, and it teaches me how the Lord loved us so much that he went to Calvary and died for our sins. Now let's go over to who won't I?
Sean and Chloe for tonight's memory verse.
All right.
From the Bible.
Hi, boys and girls. Well, boys and girls, I hope you've all been learning your memory verses over the last couple of weeks. Tonight, we're actually going to be learning a new memory verse, and it's found in John chapter 14 and verse 6. And I hope you all can see it. And it says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me.
So, boys and girls, after two, we're going to say the memory verse. So, one, two.
The Bible says in John chapter 14 and verse 6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me.
Boys and girls, this verse simply means Jesus is the only way. There's only one way to get to heaven, and that is through believing on the Lord Jesus Christ as your own and personal Saviour. So now we're going to say it again. Only this time, we're going to shout out the blanks, okay? So after two. One, two.
The Bible says in John chapter 14 and verse 6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me.
That was really good, boys and girls, but I actually think you could do a wee bit better, and we'll say the whole thing together again.
After two. One, two.
The Bible says in John chapter 14 verse 6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me.
That was brilliant. That was really good.
Trust him today, for he is the only way. Bye.
Thanks, girls, for that Bible verse. Brilliant, so it was. I hope you boys and girls all remember that for next week. I think Denise wants to share another course with you.
And then I think the workers are going to do one to finish us out. All right, here we go then.
Hello, boys and girls. You ready for the next song? It's called Jumping Up and Down. So, boys and girls, get up on your feet and do this. And do this here. Are you hitting anything? I hope not, because we need to keep this amount of space between us so we don't hit anyone or wreck any of your mummy's ornaments, because they would only shout if we did that there. So, are you ready, boys and girls? Get ready!
my wrestling and in my doubts, in my failures, you won't walk out. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa, you are the peace in my troubled sea. In the silence, you won't let go. In the questions, your truth will hold. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. You are the peace in my troubled sea. My lighthouse, shining in the darkness, I will follow you, Lord. My lighthouse, I will trust the promise, you will carry me safe to shore.
We've come to the end of another meeting and we've really enjoyed it, and we hope that you have enjoyed it too. What am I going to do with you? Well, boys and girls, I think now we'll just close in a wee word of prayer, okay? Father, we thank you for everything that's been said and done tonight. We pray your blessing to be upon it. We pray for every boy and girl who's listening that you'll bless them and bless the homes they come from. But we ask it in thy precious, holy and lovely name. Amen.
Amen.
Boys and girls, see you later. Bye. Don't forget to join us next week.